Hello, this is me from the editing studio. Because DVR alone is pretty lame, I'm trying to simply explain what's going on. This is my first pack at the World Cup track at MultiGP I.O. 2019. I've flown a little in simulator before flying this in real life. This is probably the hardest racetrack I've ever flown. It has a really weird dive gate where you have to fly up through a dive gate, a backwards power loop, and instantly crop down to the left through another metal gate. In addition to a lack of skill, I had obnoxious amounts of fail-safes, video issues, and all of that shit. Out of the 25 LiPo packs I flew at the World Cup track, maybe 22 of them included fail-safes, like partial or full dropouts. Most of them were just small freezes causing me to crash. But like you see here, it just dropped out of the sky 20 meters away from me. And I also think that's because of Crossfire and R9 users all putting up 500 milliwatts instead of a recommended 100. And since the 915 band is traveling so far, I honestly think it should be limited to maybe 10 milliwatts so more people can fly at the same time. Especially in events like this when about 100 people are flying at the same time. And here you can see my lens covers. I landed because of safety reasons, of course. I changed my lens because I thought it was just loose, but there was probably something wrong with it. I went to another channel where there were fewer people standing in line, and when I started flying, you can see that the video was absolutely horrible. So I thought maybe something was damaged on the quad, but I checked and everything was just as the pack before. So I asked around if the ground station was working properly, and they said they got perfect video over at the stand where the judges were. And that's why I asked. Maybe the coax cable from the ground station to the pilot stands was damaged, and they say no. A guy said he rigged it personally. I was just an amateur, I know nothing and shouldn't be talking about this shit. But I changed channels, everything worked fine. And some hours later, after like 5 more complaints, it turned out the cable was damaged and they had to change it. So after smashing my freestyle quad, I only brought 3 quads to this event. One freestyle quad, which I'm usually flying, and 2 racer quads I've never flown before. So I smashed the freestyle quad into the dive gate. And I did qualify at like 110, but I really don't consider it anything because I only got to fly 3 clean packs without failsafe or video issues, like I said. After that, I headed over to the freestyle track. I met some of the rubber ride guys, Simon Galgos, of course, and I also met Stan FPV. He gave me some ducts or propeller guards, which I'm going to be testing out in the future. This quad is using a frame called the Rotary Rocket. It's a racing frame. It tracks really different to the frame I'm used to flying. It has a higher camera angle and it's also a lot lighter. So the frame I've been flying for 6 months in a row smashed. So I tried getting used to this one because I had a backup. 2 quads of the racing quad and 1 freestyle quad. And I was stupid enough to destroy 2 quads over the freestyle track. One was flying racing quad along the Xylo. And somebody plugged into my channel. Sadly, I don't have DVR, so I don't have any evidence. But I saw some kid's face, and I'm pretty sure he boosted because I didn't see him after that, or he was another track powering up at too many milliwatts. Anyway, when I got video back, I was 5 meters over concrete. I smashed an arm, and that's it. So I'm surprised by the durability. It was a fall from maybe 20-30 meters, which is like 90 feet, straight into concrete, and only one arm broke. So after fixing all of the quads that were fixable, I went over to the intermediate track, flew maybe 4 or 5 packs over there. I really liked this track. It was a lot easier than the World Cup track, so I felt comfortable about flying faster. However, I didn't really know the track, so I was a constant pain in the ass for everybody else flying the track. Flying the gate through the wrong side and constantly being at risk of mid-airing someone. Overall, I think I'm going to stick to freestyle. And to be honest, overall the racing part of I.O. 2019 wasn't the best. I had the most fun outside of the racing, meeting people I've seen on YouTube, seen on Road Riot. I actually got a few of them to sign my goggles. And I had a really good time outside of races. When I was racing, everything got smashed. I think I wasted like $400 just in parts. Not a ginormous amount of money, but you know, constantly smashing everything, it kind of sucks. So this is my last quad with a GoPro I bought from a guy working at Emax. I'm not gonna say the price because it felt like a robbery. And here I'm doing a mistake again. In just a few seconds I'm at 30 and I lay my ESC. I honestly didn't think I crashed so hard, you can be the judge yourself. However, the ESC is acting really weird. You can see me testing it on the bench right now. And basically it sounds like it's about to drop the steel tray. Yeah, nigga, you still fucking with you. Steel waters run deep. I also was in a race called Two Guys, One Quad. It's basically just a little gag on, you know what, search it up yourself. It's two guys, one quad, one flying with a yaw and throttle, one flying with pitch and roll. I was flying yaw and throttle, the left stick, and one of my buddies from Norway was flying pitch and roll. So here's us getting through the track. We did cheat a little by training in a simulator, Velocidrone, flying the World Cup track in 40 seconds. This is our second try. There were three laps first where we flew five laps and crashed. We have to quickly fix our quad. Sprint back at the rookie track and flew three semi-clean laps. We actually ended up winning the event. We flew against Jesse Parkins and some other guy. Jesse Parkins is the founder of Tiny Whoop. Some betting was involved, some dirty jokes were made. In short, it was a fun little event. I like it. In a few seconds you can see Jesse Parkins and Mr. I Don't Remember Your Name handing us the famous cup.
There you go, congratulations guys.
Finish your